Hey y'all, it's Courtney, and I am back with another video. And I tried to make this video once this morning. I don't know what the hell happened. I did try to clip it because at the end my alarm started going off. It was really loud. So I tried to clip the end of the video off, but then the file got broken. So whatever, gonna just redo it. Suck it up. So I don't know if a lot of you guys will know who this is. Possibly if you are into the creepy pasta story reading channels, you might know who this is. Corpse Husband, he is now, I think he might have done like Reddit scary story readings too. I might be wrong on that one. Actually, I think it was just creepy pastas. But now he's more into the Among Us gameplay community type thing. He's the guy that has a really deep voice. If you've heard him, you know the voice. It's unmistakable. You know who it is as soon as you hear him. And there's nobody that quite sounds like him. He also has been doing music here lately. Apparently a lot of people really like it. People are like obsessed with him. And I don't know if I already said it, but Corpse Husband, you guys should go check him out. I really enjoyed his, I've been subscribed to him for a long time. Because I am subscribed to a lot of creepypasta story reading channels. Here's my new nails for Valentine's Day. Just did some silver hollow with the pink accent nail. Hollow accent nail. But anyways, so there has been some, you know, craziness going on with him on Twitter. So if you don't know anything about this situation, I'm gonna give you like a little overview, just like a little tiny explanation, the gist of it, because I'm not gonna go through all of it. But the gist is, basically, Corpse Husband was doing a live stream. So apparently his fans were getting kind of bored with the live stream and decided that they wanted to get him trending on Twitter. So what gets people all riled up better than anything else? What's a good word that you would use to get people riled up? Not in a positive way. Nay, because this is not, this word is never going to get and incite a positive outcome. His fans started trending Corpse Husband allegations. Why they chose allegations, I cannot tell you, because that is, why out of all words would you pick allegations? Because if you don't know the context to that, you're just going to assume that he's done something terrible. And a lot of people don't even know who that is. So they're just going to assume like, oh, Corpse Husband must have done something terrible. And this is not where it ends. So then the trolls get a hold of this. And you know how trolls are. They take a situation, they take a stinky dumpster, and then they go ahead and make a Molotov cocktail and catch it on fire. And then you got stinking garbage dumpster fire. So they go ahead and piece together some clips and make clips of him sounding like he's saying the N-word. They've got fake tweets made up of him saying, I groom children, or grooming children is the best, I'm a predator, I am a pedo, watch me around your kids, basically all this shit, which first off, who jokes like that? I don't know anybody in my entire life that jokes like that. Like, who raised you to joke about that kind of stuff? I can tell you one thing, somebody like me who has been sexually abused doesn't find it funny. I just don't find those kind of jokes funny. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm stupid. But I can tell you that for all the children out there that are suffering right this moment, day after day, with the fact that they've been molested or abused in one way or another, I bet you they're not laughing. All the parents out there that their children's innocence have been taken from them, and there's nothing that they can do about it. There's nothing a parent can do to fix that for their child. Parents want nothing more than to fix every little thing that happens to their child. And that is one thing that they can't fix. They can't get that innocence back. That's a piece of you that somebody takes. And you aren't willing for them to take it from you. And you can never get that piece of you back. So I guarantee you all those people, they're not laughing. I'm sure they don't find this very funny. But anyways, we're gonna put that to the side for now. So hold on. Alright, y'all. Jesus. She wanna play Minecraft! No sippy sippy. So what was I saying? I went through the Okay, so yeah, they were making like tweets that like, and I kept hearing a bunch of these channels saying everybody was fully aware that it was a joke. Everybody on the whole entire face of the planet knows that it's just a troll and it's just a joke. And when I first heard it, I didn't know that whether it was a joke or a troll. I just saw some video titles saying corpse husband allegations, and I was like, the fuck is going on? So I know I'm an old lady and I don't get the troll, and I'm the grandma over here that, you know, doesn't get the gig. No, I get the gig. It's just a stupid one. Sorry. So then corpse husband fans like lose their shit that these people made all these memes memeing the allegation tag or the allegation hashtag, and they're having fucking conniption fit that somebody furthered their narrative. But, like, why did you pick that to begin with? Why would you pick the word allegations to begin with? What did you think was going to happen? That's really the question. Like, what did you all think was going to happen? You didn't think some smartass was going to be like, oh, allegations, huh? I got something for you. You didn't think that was going to happen? I'm the grandma of the internet, and even I knew that was going to happen. Or I would assume that that was going to happen. And not to mention, not everybody knows context of these tweets. Have y'all never played telephone in school, be it elementary school or middle school? They do that to teach you a lesson. They do that so that you will not believe everything that you hear. Because, or not believe everything that you hear, but just go to the source and check things out for yourself rather than just believing what you hear wherever. And I think we all could really use that in our lives, because some of the stuff I see in the news and that kind of stuff these days, and then you find out what really happened, you're like, how did that get so twisted? But anyways, so if you've never played telephone, this is how it goes. Or we'll say this is tweets as well, because that's the example I'm going to use. So say that I tweet, or the original voicemail or phone call says, this is a joke, and the joke that I'm going to say, I'm going to meme the fact that corpse husband is a predator and a chomo, and I'm going to say that he grooms kids, but it's just a joke, okay? And by the time it gets to the 6-3 tweet and the context is gone, it gets to corpse husband is a chomo, he grooms kids, confirmed. And I know somebody that he did something to, confirmed. Like this is legit, because the context is gone. All they see is that fake tweet, and they take it at face value. They take it as at what they're reading. 6 tweets later, it's not still gonna say, oh, this is a joke, blah blah blah. It's gonna say whatever the next person that retweeted it said, then the next person, then the next person, then the next person, and eventually it loses context, or it loses the fact that it's a joke, or it loses the fact that it's a being, you know, corpse husband's being memed or whatever. Some people don't know that because they don't know the context behind it, because why would they? a lot of people, you know, have no idea. They just see something on Twitter and they're like, oh, really? I'm going to retweet that because if Twitter said it, it must be true, right? But like I said, some people, you can tell them anything and they will believe it. And then they will go and tell a bunch of other people this thing because they think it's true. They think what they're saying is the truth. I seriously doubt if they thought that they were lying about it, that they would spread the narrative. But honestly, these trolls, I think that they knew what they were doing and intentionally made these tweets to see how far this could get. As a troll, a joke, real funny joke. But once again, like, it all goes back to the initial people that started the hashtag, because why would you... I will not get over the fact, why in the world would you pick